spent most of the last few years competing on tarmac. How are you adjusting back to gravel?
It's good fun, but we're just no quick enough yet, so hopefully a bit more on the pace today. But Graham and Ewan are proving hard to keep up with them, so...
Yield in.
Hello there.
1.9 Challenge champion a few years back. Good to be back in the Challenge.
Oh yeah, it's good to be back in the Honda and whatnot. It's good. It's a nice change to 1.9205, I would say. It's a good decision. Amen.
Stephen, you've been very consistent so far as here. Two starts, two podiums. Think you can get the win today?
Hopefully we'll see how it goes. I would have preferred if it was a wee bit left. It's a bit dry. The stage is quite slippery, I think. But we'll try and push for the win today and see how it goes, I think.
Okay, third event of 2010. How do you think Stephen's progressing?
I think he's doing very well. He's getting very consistent, reliable, setting very good times. So it's just a case of keeping it on. We might not set all the fastest times in all the stages, but we're always going to get a good result at the end of the day. And that's what's important, really.
This is a car I've not seen for a long time. What's happened, Mark?
We started off the year on the Subaru license, so we decided that the budget really wasn't there to do it properly, so we thought the 205 was sitting at home, we thought we'd bring it back out, have a bit of fun and resurrect Molly. So we've done it in 3 weeks since the Jim Clark there, so a few teething problems, but the engine's going alright. I thought it's really slowed down, so we'll probably either be very quick or off.
Well done. Second in the new on the Civic section of you last year in the Brick&Steel Challenge.
See Russell's been
there. Nothing, this is Noah Craig.
How are you doing?
Well, I suppose I've really got to go and introduce the co-driver, well not.
At the end of the RSAC Scottish Rally with Stephen Smith and Russell Fair, our 205 course challenge winners today. Congratulations both of you, Stephen, your first win in challenge. You are now leading the championship, so how are you going to approach the rest of the season?
Well, we've had some good consistent results so far, and the win today has been a great addition to our championship points. But there's still a good few rounds to go, so hopefully we can keep up this consistency, keep it on the road, and score some good valuable points and keep our championship lead. We'll see how it goes.
What was quite remarkable about this win, Stephen, was that with 20 miles of the rally still to go over two stages, you were only 0.6 of a second ahead of Mark McCulloch. That's an awful lot of rally. How did you manage yourself, both mentally and physically, for the last two stages?
Well, we knew the last two stages were the longest of the day, so we had to take an approach where we took it. Because we were so close, we had to go for it in the last two, and with Mark so close in front, we knew exactly the sort of times that he was doing, and it was really good having Mark so close in front because there was quite a good rivalry between us. We could wind each other up, and it was definitely a good atmosphere. So the approach we had to take was, well, we knew Mark was going to go for it and David was very close. So we had to, basically, we had to try and beat Mark and David at their own game. So we tried very hard and it seems to have paid off.
Well, it's a fantastic polo shirt you're wearing there with lots of different logos and lots of sponsors in it. So there's clearly a lot of people behind your team. So who have been the main driving forces that have contributed to your success?
Yeah, well, this year, there's my dad's company, Neil Smith Limited. They've been really great this year, supplying tyres and then the trailer and the van. I've also got Kyle Mark Workwear Logo, who provide all the team wear, which has been fantastic, and they've just renewed their sponsorship deal for this year, so we'll be arriving on scene with new jackets very, very soon, so I look forward to that.
Well, Russell, you're one of the more experienced members of Challenge, and definitely been a key factor contributing to Stephen's success. Now, how do you feel he's developed as a driver over the last couple of seasons?
Stephen's always been very consistent, and as I say, he's a very sort of reliable driver. But what's been happening now is he's getting faster and faster, and also being consistent. He's not the sort of driver that's going to frighten you too much. You know pretty much what he's going to do and how he's going to perform. So he's very sort of consistent and just always performs at a very, very high level. As I was saying, with that, consistency is now bringing extra speed as well, which is why we're now sitting on top of the championship, I think.
Well, it's someone with a very long rallying CV, Russell. I'm guessing you've done the Scottish before. Have you ever tasted success like this on the Scottish Rally before?
Yeah, I can't actually remember what year it was, but the first year I did the Scottish Rally, it was with Stephen's dad. And at the end of that event, we were spraying champagne as well. So I think it's my second Scottish with Stephen. So my first Scottish with Stephen's dad was spraying champagne, my second Scottish with Stephen was spraying champagne, so I'm quite happy with that.